Welcome to Fixing Crap with Rob. Today, I have a flat screen TV that was graciously donated to my lawn a couple weeks ago. So instead of doing probably what I should have done, which was taking it to the electronics recycling, I decided that I would make a light for my garage out of it. So most of these flat screens these days are, especially if it's an LCD, it's backlit by LEDs. And the great thing about LEDs is they draw very little current and last forever and put out a ton of light. So it's perfect for my super dark garage. But there's a problem. Most of these new fancy TVs come with energy saver settings. So if I was to go ahead and just throw this up on the wall after I take the cracked and broken bits out, it would turn off about every 5 or 10 minutes. And unfortunately, since whoever donated this to my lawn also didn't donate the remote, I had to figure out a workaround. So I'm going to show you what to do. Step one, if you don't have a cord with it, extra unfortunate, but you go over to the Value Village and you pick yourself up one for, I don't know, nothing probably. Step two is take the whole thing apart. All kinds of fun little screws they got. Come on, why don't you focus? Yeah. Magnetic tray is real handy in this situation. Once you get that all apart, you're going to want to, I'm not going to show this because there's a couple other videos on here showing how to do it, but you basically, on the front, TVs are usually black. That is the liquid crystal display, and they get cracked real easy. So that's usually what breaks on a flat screen TV if it's thrown on a lawn. So take that out, and behind there is all these fun layers of light diffusers and polarizing filters and stuff, and I'm sure you could mess around with those. I just put them all back in. And now, to solve the problem of turning off every 5 and 10 minutes. Since you don't have an LCD, you don't need a data cable sending picture signal. So, get rid of this guy. What else don't we need? You're gonna wanna keep this main circuit board for the time being until you can figure out how to work around it. What you do is you take your handy dandy cord and you plug it right in there. And you know how to do that. So once that's on, actually, before you even do that, you're going to want to take a look at where the power goes. And once you've actually taken off the LCD screen, you'll probably figure out where the LED connection is, which in my case is right here. This is an LG LC320DXN blah 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 blah. I'm sure a lot of flat screens are similar. Yeah, here's the connection for the LED backlight. This appears to be a some sort of power converting LED driver board. And this is our main power supply board. So, what do we need to do? There's a couple other videos I've seen where guys will just take both of these guys out, rewire all these strips of LED lights in parallel with each other. I measured it. This is getting about 50 volts, so I'm not sure how many strings in there, but a bunch of them are in series because that's pretty high voltage. A lot of guys just rewire them to accept 12 volts, and then you can just use, you know, a regular power supply from most little electronics. But I don't want to do that. This TV's already got a perfectly working, hopefully you won't know until you plug it in, but perfectly good working power supply already. So instead of going out and buying a new one, I'm just gonna use what's here. So to do that, hopefully your TV will have one of these little touch power buttons on there and you'll actually be able to turn it on, give it some life and see if it actually works, if everything's going good. And once you've done that, you're gonna wanna figure out how all this works. I am not an electrical engineer. I am barely able to dress myself in the morning, so I'm not gonna understand what everything here does. But I do a little, I do loosely, so. But you don't need to understand. All you need to know is how to read little warnings like this. Caution, high voltage. You probably don't want to put your fingers in there. Might want to know a little bit. You know, you got your, so here's a transformer. You got your primary side of the circuit board. You got your secondary. You don't really need to know that, but find out information about these boards. They all have serial numbers on them somewhere, so you just send that into the old computer machine and see what pops up. I was lucky enough to find a wiring diagram and a schematic and a bunch of other information, which told me that, I don't know if you can see it, but this is the connector that goes to the main confusing board. And it's got all of the pinouts written on the board. I don't think they're always written on the board. Maybe they are, that might be a legal thing. In the schematic, I was able to read that this particular model of TV gets its power on signal from this 3.5 volt pin. And if you don't have the schematic and you can't figure that out, you're going to figure that out. You're definitely going to figure that out. You should probably figure that out. And if you can't figure that out, well, you probably shouldn't be working on this anyway. But you want to get yourself one of these handy-dandy multimeters, preferably any brand but this one. And this connection right here is, got pins on the top and the bottom. I don't know if you can see that in there, not really, but anyways, all you need to know is two sets of wires, some on the top, some on the bottom. You can see on the board we got, where's my finger? Some pinout labels there and some pinout labels on that side. They correspond to the top and the bottom of this little connector. So, next step. Oh yeah. With the TV plugged in but off, you want to go through and just check on all these different pins. It was actually helpful for me to take this board off and flip it over, but I did use my little third and fourth arm just to make sure none of it was touching this big old metal back plate and shorting anything out. You probably want to do the same. And just checking, I was just checking what pins were getting power when the TV was off. And I figured out that this 3.5 volt, these 3.5 volts were getting, sorry, these 3.5 volt pins were getting power. And to turn the TV on, you need to send 3.5 volts to this power on pin. And actually, that doesn't just turn the whole TV on, it just turns this power supply board on. I think only certain, you know, to save power while it's plugged in, you don't want electricity going through every single component on this board, so they shut off some of them. And then, from there, luckily enough, there's a little thing that says INVON, which is probably inverter. Or some other electrical word that I don't know yet. And so what I end up doing is just taking the leads from the 3.5 volt pin to the power on that turns this power supply board on, and then 3.5 volts from another pin to this inverter on pin, which I was able to kind of double check exactly what was going with the board. Flipped over, you can see all the traces, and you can follow the wires, and you can sort of take your probes and just make sure that you're getting 3.5 volts, or you're getting 24 volts, or you're getting whatever you should wherever. It's pretty nice. A lot of this board is labeled, so that's really helpful. But in a power on condition where the actual whole backlight will light up, need to have 3.5 volts to power on, 3.5 volts to the inverter on, which turns this guy on and sends somewhere around 47 or 50 volts to all the LEDs, which is a lot, but I think that helps them use much smaller conductors and etc., etc., something else. Yeah, so once you do that, you've basically bypassed all of this. You don't need the speakers anymore unless you want to do something extra fancy with those. This is the connection for, I think, the infrared sensor from the remote and whatnot. So don't need that anymore. Get rid of that guy. And you are left with a pretty bare bones looking light screen. Use it as a light. Some people use it for photography. Do what makes you happy. Just to prove that I did in fact do a thing. Oh, for frig's sakes! I must unplug something. Oh, yeah. That connector needs to be in. Ta-da! There you go. And, if you light yourself on fire, I probably can't help you. Thanks for watching.